Next on the local show, we head to the National World War I Museum in Kansas City, which not only houses artifacts and memorabilia, it is also a tribute to the service and commitment of veterans of all conflicts. KCPT producer Pam James visits with museum volunteer and Vietnam veteran Phillip Mall to learn more about how this special place honors service members and the experiences they share.
When I first came here as a volunteer, I had a lot of time sometimes to go around and look at the exhibits and read everything and study up on this. And I was struck that all wars are somewhat similar. All the people that fight in them really don't want to be fighting there. They don't. But they're there because their country called, patriotism. My undergraduate degree was in history, and I studied World War II and Korea, and of course Vietnam I lived through, and I was amazed at how similar they were, how brutal they were. But this one resonates because I think it personifies the sacrifice that men and women gave. When I read some of the stories that are here, and you just look at the pictures of the people, and in some cases how dog-tired they look and how beat up they look, it really opens up your eyes to that. This was a war that I think personifies all the wars we're in. Hi, folks. Is this your first visit to the museum?
Yes.
Where are you from?
Tucson, Arizona.
Tucson, Arizona, great place. It's somewhat easy to spot the veteran. They'll either have a ball cap on that says veteran, or they're older. And you look at somebody my age or older, you can say, chances are he served. And so you can ask. To a person, they comment on how well done the museum is. And it brings back some emotions to them. And I've had them comment that they thought that this war seemed to be dirtier, muddier, nastier than the war they fought in. The Walk of Honor struck me the minute I walked into the new museum. When you look at all those names, all the different branches of service, and you look at the names, and it's a potpourri of any ethnic group you want to think of, any race is there. I think people want to be remembered, and honored for their sacrifice. In fact, before we even went through the museum, my wife and I went out and bought a brick. And they said, what do you want to put on it? And I said, well, I'm going to put my name, but I want my wife's name too. And they said, did she serve? I said, yeah, she served at home. She made it easier for me when I was over there. The four guardians that are on the tower, you got patriotism, sacrifice, honor, and courage. And the one that strikes me the most, frankly, is sacrifice. How all the people sacrificed. And how in other wars, if you'll look, the sacrifice that went on. And I would hope that as a nation, we never forget those who sacrificed it all for our freedom.